to Fire Station 7.
Hey everybody, welcome to Station 7. My name is Dylan Murray. I'm a corporal here at Oklahoma City Fire Department Station 7. Been here for the last 8 years, and I'm excited to introduce you guys to my home away from home. And here at Station 7, we're just south of downtown, just south of the Oklahoma River, and we serve one of the oldest areas in this city. We're very lucky to, with the neighborhood of Capitol Hill, and a lot of older homes. But we're lucky enough to be at a chief station, Chief 603, one of six chief stations in the city, which I'm sure previous viewers were watching the Station 1 video, which is 601. But here we have 603 Chief's car, Engine 7 and Ladder 7, and I'll walk you through 603's car. We have Battalion Chief Mike Pascal, who's 603 on the green shift. He basically is over seven different fire stations, which is Station 7, Station 13, 16s, 23s, 28s, 36s, and 29s. He's got a big area, one of the biggest areas in the city that he serves, and so he responds to any fire, anything that warrants a chief or maybe a bigger command presence, a big incident, but he responds to pretty much any fire that's in the south, southeast, and even southwest and downtown area. So we're a very lucky spot. We respond to fires downtown, but anyway, Chief Pascal and his driver, Lieutenant Lorenzen, they have a whole slew of tools in here to help them command any miscellaneous scene. And that's kind of what hopefully you guys will find out through all these videos, is your fire department here in Oklahoma City is pretty much prepared to take care of any problem, as you saw at Station 6 with the rescue and Station 5 with the hazmat. But here on your average chief's vehicle, kind of one of the things I wanted to note, we have our drone that he'll use for maybe a large multiple alarm commercial fire or a grass fire, a large grass fire. We have SCBAs for both of them they can use on fires. They also have the cyano kits for our victims that we might extricate out of a house fire, commercial fire. And then one thing I always like to mention is we have our oxygen masks for all of our animals, our animal victims. And so, but they have miscellaneous radios to talk to other departments around the state, command boards to keep track of all the rigs that are on a scene. But anything that chief needs to command a scene and keep track of all of his people, he's got in here. One thing I also like to mention is 603, this battalion chief specifically, usually makes the most fires every year, with last year making over 350 house and commercial fires. So that's pretty interesting. So he stays a very, very busy man, has a lot to deal with. So, and now if you guys don't mind, I'm gonna pass off the camera to a coworker of 8 years, Lieutenant Mike Pierce, and also my biggest critic in the kitchen. So here we go.
Hi, my name is Michael Pierce. I'm a lieutenant here at Station 7. My primary responsibilities are to drive Engine 7 and at times fill the role of acting captain. I've been on the fire department almost 27 years, been here at Station 7 since 2015. Our rig, Engine 7, is the same as most all of our engine companies in Oklahoma City. We have four personnel at all times, one being a paramedic, making us an ALS engine company. We respond primarily to medical calls. We at Station 7 are usually in the top 3 to 5 in the city for structure fires. My job as a lieutenant would be, you know, pumping, driving, and sometimes record keeping. I'm going to pass on to Kyle Parasik, who is the ladder driver here at Station 7.
Lieutenant Kyle Parasik. I drive Ladder 7 here at Station 7 on the green shift. I've been on the fire department right at 11 years. I've been driving Ladder 7 for a little over the last 2 years. Being here at Station 7 is a big deal to us. We enjoy it. We enjoy being busy. We enjoy the camaraderie and the teamwork we have here. We're all very close on our day off as well. Ladder 7 itself is a 100-foot Pierce mid-mount ladder. It has a lot of capabilities, some ladders of past generations did not have with new technology and things. This thing's come a long way. This ladder particularly is one of the busier ladders in Oklahoma City for fires. This particular ladder in 2022 made roughly 200 fires. At this point, we're gonna go ahead and hand it back to Corporal Murray.
All right, everybody, we'll continue with the rest of the tour, the rig room. In this closet, we have our EMS supply storage. That's where we can do actually resupply after an EMS call in-house, which is really nice. So you can be ready for service immediately after. Right here, we kind of like to show people, this is our kind of break table. We kind of adopted this table that was sitting on the side of the road and added all of our own little personalities to it. You have stickers from conferences that guys do. A lot of guys here train on their days off or teach at conferences or part of the fools. And so you'll see miscellaneous stickers for trainings, for some guys are gearheads into cars. You got race wheel stickers. So it's just kind of a way to show each other what we're into, what our personalities are, and kind of make this more of a home, you know, than an office. So, but there's the grill. That's where a lot of magic happens and a lot of mistakes happen, depending on how busy our day is and depending on who's cooking. But that thing goes through a lot of wear and tear and it's held up and we're glad that it has. But anyway, we'll go this way. To touch on the point of training, like we talked about, all those stickers and the conferences, we have an in-house forcible entry prop. So this is how all of us incumbents, even our recruits, you know, tune up our skills on forcible entry for residential commercial fires, makes us more efficient at our skills. So we usually try and train every day for at least 2 hours, whether it be on medical stuff, on fire stuff, you got ropes, dive, I mean, you name it. So here's one of our tool closets. Fridays are actually our rig day. So on Fridays, we'll do an in-depth cleaning of all the rigs in the station. That's how it is citywide. But we spend a lot of time in here. We have grinder wheels. We have WD-40. We got everything you need to tune up our tools and anything that the rig might need some help with, so. Next, we'll move into the bunker closet. I always like showing people the bunker closet because there's kind of a lot of silent stories told in here. You have everybody's off-duty, all of our off-duty personnel, which here at Station 7, we have the three shifts, red, blue, and green shift, and each shift roughly has about 12 personnel on each shift. Starting over here, you have our battalion chiefs and our majors and our captains, which are our officers. And you guys, we'll see here in a little bit, Major Gapehart, he's a ride out for our battalion chief, Mike Pascal. And over here on this wall, you have all of our drivers on every shift, whether it be drivers of 603's car, the engine, or the ladder. And then here in the middle and mixed match, we have all of our firefighters' gear. So you'll see some are missing their gear. Some guys might be loaned to different stations, or a lot of times they might be cleaning their gear next door, and I'll show you where that's at. So, you know, as in the last, I'd say a couple decades in the fire service, you know, we've kind of started to do a big push for anti-cancer because, you know, we have a lot of carcinogens that we go into in these house fires, and all the hazmat guys you saw in the previous Station 5 video, they deal with a lot of chemicals and a lot of hazardous materials. So we've been lucky enough for the city, and thank you to the citizens providing us for all this nice equipment. But we have our gear extractor back here, which we can actually clean our gear in-house. Whether if we make a very dirty fire or a dirty call, if we any bodily fluids, smoke, anything. So that's very nice to have here in the station. And here we have a cascade system. This is another awesome thing that we have in-house. So when we return from any kind of a call that we use our SCBA on, you know, majority of them being fires, we can fill all of our air bottles from the rigs in here. That way we don't have to go anywhere else and we can be prepared for the next call as soon as possible. So one thing I kind of like to touch on, you might have seen a dog bed right here. Here on Blue Shift, we have a USAR canine owner on Blue Shift. And so he's part of the USAR team and has a canine dog. And I really think that's pretty cool. His name's Zip and we like to see him in the mornings. He cheers us all up, so. That's pretty much it for Station 7's rig room. If you guys would like, we'll move inside and I'm gonna hand it off to Major Gapehart for a little history lesson.
My name is Major Wiley Gapehart. I've been here at Fire Station 7 for about a year and a half now as my assignment. However, when I first came on the job, this is where I was first assigned back in 2008. So looking at the history of Capitol Hill and our fire station here, Capitol Hill was in 1900, Mrs. Boyd bought this land and then later sold that 160-acre tract to a guy named Mr. Harrington. He laid it out. Originally, Capitol Hill, the town, was from Walker to Santa Fe, 22nd down to 29th Street, and that was as big as Capitol Hill was at the beginning. The fire department, Capitol Hill Fire Department number 1, originally was at Southwest 25th and Robinson, or Commerce and Robinson. And we believe this is that picture. And you can see the fire chief right here as well. So this is from 1902, one of our oldest pictures. Pretty cool. Not a whole lot in the background, as you see. As we move along, around 1910, which Capitol Hill was its own city, it was incorporated in 1904. In 1909, Oklahoma City took a vote to annex Capitol Hill into its city. And so this is a picture of the fire station right after that happened. It was built right around that same time. And I think in January 26th, I looked up, was their first call out of that fire station as fire station number 7. So we go from Capitol Hill station number 1, or they refer to it as Capitol Hill Fire Department. And what I think is kind of neat there is you can hear them talk about in the newspaper articles, Capitol Hill Fire Department, all the way up until the mid 50s. That's just what the residents knew it as. But Oklahoma Station, station number 7, which was just where 23rd and Robinson, in between Robinson and Harvey. This station right here was built on 24th and Harvey, right on the corner, 2500 South Harvey. It was later rebuilt on the same site in 1945. And you can see that picture there. It was pictured just after that. It was remodeled. You can see an addition of a hose tower and an extra little room there. So it was remodeled later then. And then in 1983, they built the current station that we're in right now, 218 Southwest 23rd. And so that's what happened there is there are some structural problems with it later on, right at, around the time I came on the job. And then they remodeled it and reopened it in 2009. So this station has some of the same walls as what's pictured here, but they just use those walls to remodel it. So if you come down here, you can see the fire station as it is now. So anyway, that's a brief history of Capitol Hill and Capitol Hill's fire station, Oklahoma City Fire Department number 7, fire station number 7.
All right, everybody. So you guys just talked to Major Gapehart, and speaking of Major Gapehart, we're here in our first hallway from the rig room, and down this hallway we have our Major's office, or you'll hear some people refer to him as our station officer. And we also have, it's labeled Major office, and we actually have a junior officer here at Station 7 as well, due to us having an engine and a ladder. A lot of times I have two officers here, and so kind of out of a traditionally respect thing, you know, they made rank, and they have a lot of stuff they have to deal with every day from day to day with the district and the station, so they have their own offices with their own bathrooms, computers, books, you name it. So it helps them take care of what they need to take care of day to day. But down this hallway, we'll kind of get into the guts of the station. So down this hallway, you have all the bedrooms, individual bedrooms for firefighters and drivers. And it's just like I said earlier, it's a home away from home. We have our clothes here. We got pictures of our family in our lockers. We got shoes, underwear, t-shirts, pants, you name it. And basically it lets us, you know, able to stay ready for anything that we need to do and go off work the next day and for the next shift to come on. So. But anyway, we'll go ahead and keep moving. And down this hallway, we have our chief's office. As I said, Battalion Chief Mike Pascal. And he actually is one of the last remaining firefighters that responded to the bombing. He's got almost 35 years on, responded to the May 3rd tornado. So we're very lucky to work, you know, with a chief that has that much experience and knowledge. So on this wall, we have pictures of some of our older rigs. These were actually the three vehicles that were previous to the ones you just saw in the rig room, a 603 engine 7 and ladder 7. We also have some miscellaneous awards that we've received as a station or as a rig at our yearly annual firefighter banquet. And as you can see behind you, we have these two shadow cases, which we think are really, really cool. We have our some of our old yearbooks. We have some memorabilia. We actually have, I'm sure, some people that have been keeping up to date with all of our social media stuff on the fire department are Project Life with our smoke alarms. We actually have some smoke alarms that have saved people and been burned up in a fire. So we keep those as a reminder that, you know, us installing smoke alarms is just as important as training or medical rides. So, but and behind you, just to pay homage to all the firefighters that have passed before us, here are several obituaries for firefighters, active or retired, that have passed, and kind of a way that, like I mentioned about tradition, you know, we love to keep them in our memory and make sure they're not forgotten. So we'll move here into the watch office. Now that it's the 21st century, we have a lot of computer training now and a lot of online training. So in this room, we do the majority of our record keeping, whether it be records for calls, records for our training, and but we have this nice room that we have this nice computers and nice window. We can see all of our neighbors and our neighborhood, and that's kind of one thing we always kind of pride ourselves on here at Station 7 is we're one of the only stations that's still in a residential street, which I think is really cool. It lets us stay close to the people that we serve in the neighborhood. So anyway, we'll go ahead and keep moving. I won't bore you guys, so we'll move down here, and this is where all the world's problem solving goes on. So we're here in the kitchen. We have these firefighters hard at work and acting like they're talking about something important. And now we have, as you can see, we're always in here, whether it be training out in the rig room or out at a site that we've chosen to throw ladders, pull lines. We'll also watch helmet cam videos of ours from previous fires, almost just like watching film for a football game or a basketball game. Ways we can critique ourselves and make sure we get better every day. But right here, we have the epitome of health, a chocolate covered yellow cake, and we have the kitchen where a lot of debates, a lot of conversations, and a lot of eating and griping goes on. But speaking of griping, there's Pierce that you just saw earlier. But we'll go ahead and move on. One thing I'll point out, each shift has their own food locker. That way each shift that comes in, basically when they come in on duty, it's like the station wasn't touched by us or the previous shift. So they come into a fresh, clean slate. They have their own food locker. They have all the food they need and everything else they need to eat and keep their bellies full. But we'll move into this room. This is our day room. It's a little different than most stations, but our day room is right here behind the kitchen. And when we're lucky enough to have some downtime, usually here at Station 7, being a chief station, if we aren't running calls, if we aren't training, we're usually doing, you know, public education stuff or going to do building walkthroughs. But whenever we do get the slight chance of having downtime, we have a nice room that, you know, we can relax. And we also have pictures that pay homage and an ode to the firefighters that came before us and all of the scenes that Station 7's responded to. So out here is where the competition comes to a head, the volleyball court. I'm sure a lot of people have seen it in movies and heard about it, and it's real. We have a volleyball court, and you know, they say there's no rank on the volleyball court, and that's where a lot of competition and team building goes on. Speaking of volleyball and fitness, here's our weight room. Every shift, you know, we have an allotted time to stay physically fit and, you know, work out and stay in shape for a job that's very physically demanding, mentally and physically. And we have this nice big weight room with all these weights and all these machines provided to us. To make sure that stays happening. So in here we have a washer and dryer, just like we talked about, home away from home. We have, this way we can wash our uniform clothes here at the station instead of taking our clothes back home to our wife and kids that might have any contaminants, smoke, whatever else on them. So here we can wash them and make sure that work stays at work and home stays at home. So, but back there we have our bathrooms, male and female restrooms just behind the bedrooms. And after that, guys, that's pretty much it. That's Station 7 for you. Hey guys, so as you've probably seen previously in the station tour, we have a motto here at Station 7 that we like to live by. That's expect fire and expect victims. And basically that keeps us vigilant, and you know, no call is a false call. And any fire that we go into, we expect to find a fire victim, which keeps us, you know, non-complacent with our training, our 911 response. But anyway, thank you so much for coming, guys. We're here located at 218 Southwest 23rd Street. Keep an eye out for the next station tour, and we're here if you need us.